Ordinarily, the lightest of sound woke him. A car turning a corner half mile away, a cat racing across the front lawn. A silent scream escaped from somebody else's nightmare. But on this night of all nights, he didn't stir. Didn't roll over in a last-ditch effort to escape the disturbance, as if that's all it would take. Didn't mumble a pleaful cry. As doors opened, drawers opened and slammed shut, through the mixed and matched footsteps on carpeting and clattering on hardwood floors. Despite the muttered coughs and murmured curses, or as a front door creaked shut. Perhaps that's why she left it, because she knew that at this most vital of times, when life's sorrows and joys were wrapped around one another, not in a fight to the death, but for a conviction. He would sleep through the experience, and in the morning dismiss it as just another one of her dreams. Something familiar, looming off to the side, there but not there. Another one, another distraction, a forehead. That's it. About to connect, but the eyes to which it is to join don't match. One is narrow and blue, the other wide and brown. And the cheeks that come into view don't belong, are too smooth, too pale. The lips, thin, misshaped, chapped. Then it, the image of a stranger's face, something familiar but unknown, recedes and rolls away. No shelter will protect us from the intentions of the disquieting sky. Its portent will find us, loom over us, haunt us, no matter where we hide. Happy Halloween.